G'day guys, well I'm here with my good mate Frank. He's the smartest bloke at Elite Power. And we've just done the unboxing video for the Zappi Charger, and this is a bit different and it's got a CT clamp. Tell us about CT clamps, Frank. What are they and why are they important?
They're only a simple little device, but they're so powerful in what they can tell us. They are actually look like this, and they have a hole through the middle through which an active lead will throw, and this will connect to the Zappi. All it is a whole lot of turns inside, and it...
Like a coil.
A coil. Yep. And it will detect the current flowing in this larger conductor, which is usually right at the house entrance where the grid goes to the grid. Now they can measure the current flowing in that wire, and they can measure the direction in which the current is flowing. So if it's coming from the grid, it knows that it's coming from the grid.
So you're drawing power, the house of power.
And if it's sending energy to the grid, it knows that there's being an export of energy from the solar.
Yeah, and that's now, where this kicks in.
Exactly. What the Zappi does is it looks at the numbers coming out of this and says, okay, there is energy, there's a certain amount of energy going out to the grid. The customer has requested, or this has been set up to request a certain amount of energy going into the car.
Yep.
And as long as there's, and he's put a criteria, say the user has said, I only want to charge my car from excess solar.
Yeah, it has that. That's the Eco Plus mode.
Yep. Right. So all it does then, it says, well, is there that minimum amount of power going out from the house to the grid?
Yep.
If it is, let's turn this on and let's send precisely that amount of energy into the car.
Yeah, very
now,
clever.
If a cloud comes over and suddenly the solar drops, then this will say, whoops, there's not enough going out to the grid for me to fully activate, so I'll just be quiet for a while. The cloud disappears and it becomes very sunny. More and more power is available as we reach midday, and this will progressively look at the amount that is potentially exported, and it will ramp up the amount of power that it's sending to the car.
So I noticed
there's a balancing trick between the two.
I noticed when I went through the manual in this, I noticed this had three modes when I looked at it. So there was a boost mode, so that's no matter what's happening, I want charge to go into my EV. Yeah. There was an Eco mode and an Eco Plus. So what you just spoke about is the Eco Plus setting. So it will throttle down and it'll go to sleep if there's nothing being produced. Mm. So it's measuring, are we exporting? If we're exporting, charge the vehicle. If we're not exporting, don't charge. And then it's got the Eco mode. So the Eco mode will still pull from the grid a little bit. It'll supplement from the grid.
Say, it'll take what it can. If you're asking it for a certain amount, it will say, well, I can measure how much is being exported, so that's fine. And the surplus, the remainder, I'll take from the grid.
Yeah, great. So if you have solar at home and you're going to get set up with an EV charging, and you would love to prioritise using your own solar, then I think these guys were the first to market with a smart EV charger that gives you multiple ways of utilising your own solar to charge your electric vehicle. Yeah. So did you know these guys kicked off with a crowdfunding for this product?
Did they?
That's how they started. So
they're English, I think.
Yeah, English company, went on Kickstarter, people got behind the product and then put money in, and that launched them, and then now they're into version 2 and they're away. Yeah.
What I do like about the Zappi is it's got a very good graphical interface here. The user interface is a little pictorials of the house, the car, the grid, etc., with power flows shown as in real time, and it gives you at a glance, you can see exactly what's happening with the system.
Yeah, there you go.
You know, and it's got little words in there that tell you what's happening.
That's a surplus situation there, where you've got surplus power, you're producing it, the house is using some, and then we're putting some into the car. Mm. So it's using the surplus from the house to put into the car, and it can balance. So these are all the different modes that you can go through. And this is the three modes I was talking to you about. Fast mode, so you want to, no matter what's happening, you want to put some charge into your car, Eco or Eco Plus.
Yeah.
And Eco Plus is that one that we mentioned. Yeah. So it will only work if you're producing solar. So what happens then, Frank, if you went from sunny to cloudy? It'll just throttle down?
And if it's dropped to a certain amount, it would just switch off. I think it goes into a waiting mode where it's waiting for some solar.
Waiting for EV. Yeah.
So there'll be a minimum threshold where it will say, well, look, there's not enough. Really, I'm not going to put 2 watts into the car. I'm just going to wait until it comes back to a reasonable value, and then I'll start again. And it's all the information that it needs to do these calculations comes from this little thing called CT.
CT clamp.
Such a simple little gadget.
I mean, it's just, when you look at it, you go, that's just makes sense, but it just took somebody to actually start doing it, and I'm sure probably a lot of EV chargers now do it, but these guys were the first. And they're now in Australia, they've got an office here, and we're getting people that are doing the homework, Frank, and they're contacting us about the Zappi. Yeah. So,
Jason, too, I've looked through the book and it's very well written. The documentation in this book.
You love really a good documentation manual, don't you?
I do. I like things to be written in plain English, not to have meanings which you don't understand. It's pitched very well, actually, so that I'm pretty sure that people buying one of these would be very happy with the purchase.
And what do you think of our high budget table that we've knocked up here from a couple of old shipping container pallets?
I think it's unique, actually. I don't know of any other YouTube channel which has such an elegant, minimalist unboxing platform.
Nothing's wasted, Frank. Repurpose the packaging if we can to our set. So make sure you like, subscribe, check our website out. Thanks for sharing with us, Frank, about CT clamps.
And ring that bell.
Yeah, give us a call. And Zappi Charger, have a look at the unboxing video we did for the Zappi Charger. And all of these things are on our website. And great product. Happy to support it. A bit unique about these, they make a tethered and an untethered version. So this is the untethered version. So you just get the socket, bring your own plug. Yeah. So which is a bit of security, but also people like carrying a plug in the car because they go to some of these EV chargers where it's BYO, bring your own BYOP, BOYOP, bring your own plug.
All the new words that are creeping into the lexicon these days with renewables.
Well, there you go. CT clamps. That's part of the new
CT
lingo.
CT stands for current transformer.
Current transformer clamp. Yeah, right. Good on you. Thanks for watching. See ya.
Bye.